let's get it on.
Yeah, this is the same to do. We don't need.
We have fun stuff ahead.
How until you know what I have to catch. Yep.
There's all kinds of stuff to see and do. You're just staying in the same old spot, stuck in a rut. Yeah, let's get moving. That's right. You got it. You got it. All right, well, we've made a little progress. Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Get on with it. We got things to do and things to see.
One thing I'm trying to struggle with on the sketch is to.
Alright, I want to put you on my finger and we're going to go for a ride. Can you handle it? I'm going to need you to trust me. Okay? We'll go nice and slow. Alright, hold on. Patience and trust.
Oh shit, that means
patience.
Emotion to impound.
And trust.
I mean, wouldn't that involve your car? That would mean they would hold your car somehow.
Yeah, that wasn't so bad. You let me get my finger really close. You didn't get on, that's okay. We're getting there slowly. And I'm cool with that, okay? I'm gonna go look for Charlie. I'll see you in a little bit.
I mean,
I'm proud of you.
I think only pertains to cars.
Good job. Good job.
I don't know.
I'm ready, let's go. You've been hanging out in here for so long. Don't you want to see some other stuff? Do some other things? Can we please go? Just a little bit. Sure. Let's check out some other things. You can do it. You're just gonna be that still? All right, I'm going to look for Charlie again. See you later. Well, you doing? What's new? Anything? You're still hanging out in the same area. You haven't gone much. Do you have two dots on each eye? Holy shit. Can I see the other eye? Can you turn your head a little bit? Just a little bit? So I could see the other eye. I want to see if there's two dots on that one too. No? Yes? There's definitely two dots there. That's just one eye, right? Oh, I'm confused by you. Can you turn your head a little bit? Just a little bit. No kisses? No kisses? Come on, turn your head a little bit. You're no fun. You're no fun. Just kidding, you're plenty of fun. I just wish you'd just turn your head a little bit. Why can't you? That's all you need, huh? You got your eye on me. Well, I'm gonna smoke a bowl. You wanna smoke a bowl? Yes? Okay, hold on. Get any of that? I'm not sure you did. If you turn your head, I'll know you did. Otherwise, God damn it. Otherwise, we're gonna smoke some more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're gonna smoke more. Did you get some that time? Maybe? A little bit? I haven't seen Charlie all day. You haven't wanted to do anything. This heat is just too much, I think, for everybody. I don't know what else to say to you, but I'm gonna smoke you out a little bit more and hopefully you'll feel better, okay? All right. I can tell by your antenna you like what I'm saying to you. Did you get some that time? Speak to me, O wise one. What have you got for us today? Let's speak of cosmic things. Or let's go for a walk. Neither? Nada? All right. I'm going to look for Charlie. I'll see you later. Bye. Good morning, guys. Listen, we have a visitor. He's in the house somehow. I'm gonna take him outside with me. We're gonna smoke a bowl. You wanna smoke a bowl? Yes? Okay, hold on. Good morning. I found this little guy in the house. As soon as I opened the blinds this morning, he was on the window in the house. In the house. Whoa! Dude. Holy shit, are you okay? I'm supposed to jump like that. Holy. Charlie, is that you? How'd you get in the house? How you doing? I can't believe you. You just jumped so far. You scared the hell out of me. Are you doing pretty good? All right, we're gonna smoke a bowl, okay? Hold on, I got you. All right, I gave you a really good puff just now. Hold on, hold on. about? So fast this morning. I'm always asking you guys to get on the move. I guess I shouldn't complain, huh?
I never tried that one, but did you ever hear that one? No, but I've been it. This is a little off, but I've been it.
How far are you going up this?
Someone's like, hey, the Coke dealers, get your money ready. The Coke dealer's gonna be here in 20 minutes. And fucking like dogs, Pavlovian, and everyone starts taking shits in 10 minutes.
Ooh. Maybe you should eat that guy. Where'd he go?
It works on me. You would work on me too. Coke dealer's coming at your front and taking shit.
I don't even understand.
I didn't know that either. Is that why
you're way up there now?
That's why you shit when you do a line of coke, because there's laxatives in it.
That's what they say. Yeah, that's one of the things they mix it.
I can't even with you.
Wow. This is the last time I FaceTime with someone.
Going really, really, really high. You're making me nervous. Are you going to the bee house?
Yeah, but no pants on.
All the time. Duh. Come on, man. They can't see the body. They can't see that part of you. So why do you have to have freaking pants? And that's just comfortable. A lot of times I have boxers on, though, because, you know, your butt cheeks sitting on a leather chair.
Oh, yeah. I don't like being naked too much. I like underwear.
Yeah, I'm an underwear man myself, yeah. But I'll just have on my, like, sliders, my
whatever. I can't. Holy shit, you're up high. How do you feel? Pretty good?
I mean, they're like these short ones. They're like, I don't know if you guys can see, like this.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm telling you, before I was, this is fucking, I don't know, 20 years ago. But before him, I don't think I'd ever seen these. You see these kind of underwear?
You're up super high.
Oh, wow. So they're kind of nuts up here.
Yeah. And I'm kind of...
Are you going to the bee house?
I underwear 2 or 3 times a day. Not that they're ever dirty, but I just like fresh underwear. And then once it starts, like, I'm in for the night, then I put on boxers and a pair of sweats.
I respect that. Wow. So you got, like, business. You got your business underwear. And then you're... I just like these...
I wanted to head to the bridge.
But
you had other plans. I don't know if that's you, Charlie. I don't think you're Charlie. Yeah, you're not Charlie. Who are you? You're in my house. You're in the house. You're almost to the bee house now. Holy shit. How is that? Are you going for it? With these flies. All right, get to the house. I'll see you later. You are under the house. You're under the house. Now you're really under the house. I guess this is a great way to catch bees. It is a bee house. We know you guys eat bees, so I'm gonna come around the other way, check you out from that angle. This is a little much. All right. Should I name you Bambeco? Just call you Becco for short. Yep, there it is. What's up, Becco? What's up, Becco? Sorry, Becco.
I don't understand how they can't just think logically for a second. Can you imagine letting your boy stick money into a grown man's, like, bikini underwear?
Yeah, I love it. Now look at that.
We're talking about drag queen story time for kids. Or where they went to the bar and let the kids come for drag time and gave them dollar bills to give to the drag queens. Oh, I can't with it. I can't. Ben Becco. 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 Yo, Becco. What's up? So you're on the Bee House. Let's check it out, okay?
Yes, yes.
I'm going to go around to the front of it. Oh, this hummingbird is right over my head. Oh god, okay. So here's the Bee House. And it's got all these holes in it. When we got it, it was nice and clean. All the holes were empty.
Look at this.
The bees come and they fill it with their goo. I don't know what it is. It's not honey, I can tell you that. Not that I've tried, I just know. It's something else.
But the boys and the boys wearing a gay pride shirt.
Yeah. There's my boy. What's up? So, if the bees come flying over here to lay their droppings of whatever, my boy is in place. Drag shows for children. What the fuck?
And it was a transgender person. I think it was a dude who was now a chick or something. I can't remember. And I don't even like using that word transgender. It's like, I don't like using the word abortion. I just want to say what it is. Abortion is termination of a baby, fertilized egg, and this was a woman who's now a man. And they were telling Matt Walsh that they were watching anime. And a wolf ran across the screen, and they realized they were a wolf. What the fuck? I was on LSD watching Ren and Stimpy, and I thought I was a mouse all of a sudden. Like, the origins of your identity came from a television set? I mean, that right there just shows you how fucked up it is.
Yeah, and I'll tell you one more thing.
You're speaking truth. What are you going to do? Hear it, you better hear it. You better tell it. You better tell it. I love Alex. Love you, Alex. All right, we gotta get you a TikTok. Yes, Bibble. Yes, Bibble. I love you. See you later.
Bro, what? I don't know nothing about that.
The J6 hearings, how do you feel about them?
They are nothing that I know about. I don't know what this is.
Okay, what do you guys think about the January 6th hearings that are happening in D.C. right now?
Have you seen Becco?
That looks like a politician.
Definitely is.
They're all snakes. My question for you is, what are your thoughts on the January 6th hearings?
The January 6th hearings? I have no idea.
What are your opinions on the January 6th hearings happening right now?
I don't know what's going on right now.
Do you know about the January 6th hearings?
No, I don't know what it is.
Nobody really does. So what are you guys' thoughts on the January 6th hearings that are happening in D.C. with Pelosi right now?
I'm starting to worry that you might be depressed.
Suck some goddamn dick.
That's what I say too. She sucks.
I think you need something.
How much money did she cost us, Donald Trump?
I don't know what it is.
Prove? Nothing. She wasted taxpayer money twice. Not once, twice.
I can't get
biggest
in that
biggest television
good.
Event oh. in history they're saying right now is the J6 hearings that are going
What's
on.
What's up? Am I disturbing you? Or would you like to play?
What are your thoughts on the January 6th hearings that are happening?
Wanna go do something?
In history right now?
I don't even know what the fuck that is, but
we could.
I don't know.
It could be
the
fun.
J6 hearings that are going on right now, they say it's the biggest event.
All right, think about it. I'll come back later, okay? See you later.
That's what they're saying ratings-wise, so I'm wondering how you're doing.
What are you telling me?
Because you probably have a life. It's just crazy. I just
don't. You don't like what I'm listening to? All right, hold on. I'm going to turn it off. I'll be right back. Give you a little bit.
Sons and daughters of planet Earth. Good evening, my dear friends. This is Ashton. I am very happy to be here with you this evening to share information and the love that we can share together in these momentous times. Please relax yourselves and be comfortable. And I will give you an introduction. I would like to address some information concerning the Ashtah Command, our purpose, who we are, and what we are doing here speaking to you in this strange manner. So you have been introduced to this ascension idea, this plan of ours. Let me say it is a plan of the Christs, under whose auspices we are working directly. I would like to speak a little bit about my role and the role of the Ashtah Command.
I have an idea. I have a treat for your eyes. I think it's going to really trip your eyes out. It's going to be like you're tripping balls, but it's just holograms, okay? You want to try it? All right, hold on.
The human species. We have from time to time manifested physically, but largely we work spiritually. There may come a time, probably there will come a time, when you will see our ship lower our dimensional time and space. Nevertheless, we are here and we are fully functioning. In fact, at this time our efforts have been redoubled, and we have a great number of fleets.
Come on.
Surrounding the
Let's
planet
go.
Doing much work. Our
Let's
work
go for
consists of many different areas.
Come on.
Largely, we are assisting in the elevation of consciousness.
Look, this one tricked me. I thought that was you.
We'll be meeting with the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. Is there any kind of promise beforehand that the Saudis will increase production?
No, there's no promise beforehand. There's not. And let me just say, John, we really want to see us move to clean energy, but we also need to see this increase right now. And we are asking the oil and gas companies as well to diversify and make sure that that they become diversified energy companies to be able to produce other means of clean energy, because they have huge deep pockets. They have a big ability to invest in the future as well as investing right now, so that we don't see oil and gas causing the inflation numbers and people being hurt every day.
Yeah. of Venezuela that you recognize.
But I want to talk about who is here. Who is here as the President of the United States and has been said 4 years ago the President did not attend. Constraints that COVID has played. We have a war in Iraq. We have COVID, which has really...
We have a war in Iraq.
Put this inflation in context. How bad is the surge of prices?
It's awful. I mean, it's awful, and how people feel about it is even worse. You know, you look at the consumer sentiment right now, and what do you see? This is the worst consumer sentiment ever measured by the University of Michigan, going all the way.
Consumers feeling this bad? Well, it's pretty clear why they're feeling this bad, and that is because the consumer price index is the worst it's ever been in a midterm cycle since 74. It's the worst it's been in any presidential cycle or midterm cycle since 1980. So it's not much of a surprise. You can see it. It's literally off the charts on the table on your screen.
And where, how does President Biden's performance rate?
Awful.
I mean, I knew that was the answer. The answer is awful. I mean, you know, I'll compare it to Carter at this point in his presidency, right? Look at the disapproval rating Joe Biden has in inflation right now. It's over 70%. Carter was not even there at this point in mid-1978. When you're doing worse than Jimmy Carter's doing in the minds of Americans and inflation, you know that they're holding you responsible for the conditions that are currently on the ground that are hurting Americans in their pocketbooks.
With all the crazy stated plans, the Great Reset, the currency reset, even the food reset, it's not a matter of if.
Down the body and you go on to what is called heaven, then there will be the place where you reside forever and ever and ever. In some ways, this is true.
Becco, did you go in the bee house? Because I can't find it. It's too hot to get up right now. I looked, but I didn't see you. Like, we have a strawberry moon right now. There's a strawberry. Well, Becco, I hope you're doing okay. Come out when you want to, and we'll see you then, okay?
And it's not to say how those manifests
later.